Because you with my best friend.
I know what you hookers are thinking. When did we get here? Just go with it.
I got a whooping. Me, I got a whooping because this nigga stole my phone. I'm gonna act out. And if you wanna act out, we can act out. Fuck you. Thank you very much. I was first. Tia Tamara, wait, Tia Tamara, wait, Tia Tamara. They said Doja hit so sticky, I said thank you very much. Bent the whole world over and says thank you very much.
Hey guys, y'all know it's your favorite YouTuber. Stop the applause. Stop the applause, guys. I'm being serious. It's your favorite YouTuber. Your favorite person under God. Individual. Let your name be sanctified. Anyway. Okay, I'm gonna be telling y'all about my experience. Yeah, I'm basically gonna be telling a story time as I do a wig install. Yeah. Now, I'm gonna do a quick recap. I got food poisoning this week. I cooked some bad chicken. I didn't know it was bad. And after I cooked the bad chicken, I ate the bad chicken. And that made me shiver, quiver, and die. And then I came back to life. And they told me you're still not that gross.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
Nah, but like, basically I was throwing up in the bathroom and whatnot on Christmas Day. It was such a great experience. Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
Alright. I know what you hookers are thinking. When did we get here? Just go with it.
I'm gonna tell the story time of how I got my phone stolen. Of how he stole my phone, sent me a dick pic, and texted my dad. Okay, y'all. I noticed for the remaining of the video, I say he stole my phone and sent me a dick pic. He took dick pics on my phone and then proceeded to send my dad text. About how he had my phone.
This how press it. Ah! What the fuck?
We're gonna name him Z. Me and Z had been dating. Well, we called ourselves dating because we was like really young. We fell out because he got with my best friend, ex-best friend, fake friend. I'm gonna call her Claire. Now, Claire was real musty, dusty, and ugly. And she really, like, I don't know how she stole my man. But she did. After that, I got his homeboy, but that's another story time. Basically, we call ourselves dating, and you know, we acting cool, we're reading our little books together, because you know, it's, and I didn't mention this, but this happened in the second grade. He literally stole my phone, sent me a pic, and then texted my dad from my phone and said, yes, I have her phone. Yes, I have London's phone. The balls on this little boy. And that's why I feel like he learned that from his big brother, because his big brother was in the fifth grade, or wait, was in the second grade. But that's neither here nor there. Basically, I put my phone inside of my book bag that was also inside of my cubby. You know, we was a little hard-headed kids, so I had my phones out when my teacher, we gonna call him Mr. Rock. This is really close to his actual name. Like, Claire, Z, and Rock, those are like real close to their actual names. But he told me to put my phone up or he was gonna take it. So I put my phone up inside of my cubby, inside of my backpack. Fast forward to when it's actually time to go, I grab my book bag and I'm looking rapidly for my phone. Did not find it. So when I tell you, and my mama told me not to have my phone out at school unless, like, y'all know, like, the little driveway where they pick up the kids and the kids be sitting down the little sidewalk when the teacher, like, calls them and tells them, this is your car, this is time to go. Basically, she told me not to have it out unless we're literally about to go home. And I was inside of the classroom and I had it out. And that let people know that I had the phone. So me and Bae already had gotten into an argument. Because of Claire. I said her name. Because of Claire. And is it tacky? It's tacky enough. I'm tired of this. I don't want to mess it up. But, like, I feel like it's tacky. Maybe I should put some foundation on it, correct?
Correct.
Now, I'm just going to use some regular foundation. I'm literally freaking out because my mama already told me not to have my phone out in school. She already told me not to have my phone out in school, but me being a hard-headed little behind girl, I had my phone out in school. I go home, act like everything is fine. Now, I don't know why. I don't know how, but, like, how she knew that I did not have my phone. Basically, she said, Lena, where your phone at? Maybe I was getting on it after school, but I really don't remember that now because, like, I'm literally in 11th grade. I told her that someone stole it or it's at school. And she literally does the U-est of U-turn. Exactly like that. And why do you tell me? Like, she's going off. She's going off because at this point, I had lied to her maybe twice. I said, it's in my book bag. She said, give it to me. I said, I'm going through my book bag. I can't find it. She looks at me with the most, like, I know you're bullshitting me look. She goes off as she should, like, literally. And my mom comes up to the school, and if I'm not mistaken, I think my dad came up to the school. No, that was a different occasion, because I got a couple of school stories I'm about to tell on this channel. She gets mad at me because she said, why didn't you tell me, like, I'm halfway from the school, and, like, oh, and let me tell y'all what school, I should tell y'all what school I went to and be messy. My mama goes up to the school, and she raises hell. My mama's mad, like, real mad. And fast forward, a couple weeks pass, and my mom and my dad sets up a reward money for the phone, because I have not had my phone in a little while. They set up reward money for the phone, and they said it's in the class, whoever finds my phone gets $50. Someone comes up with the phone. We're gonna call him Sean. So Sean comes up with the phone, but he leaves the school the previous day. Like, he literally got out of school the previous day. Like, he, like, left the school. Like, he went to a completely different school. I'm trying to get through my phone. And I could not crack the password. Now, keep in mind, the boy's name is Z. My brother, at the time, I thought he was a genius. He was actually just thinking logically, and I was, like, really dumb. So, basically, he says, what's the boy's name? I said, Z. He tries the Z. And it comes open. We go through the camera roll. The first thing we see is a dick pic. Actually, the first thing we saw was some pictures of Zamir and his brother. But, yeah. And then we saw the dick pic. I go tell my mom, I'm like, is this a knee? Like, is this a knee? Because, like, I'm still innocent. I don't know what that is. Now, my brother, he for sure knows what that is. And I think he's actually the first person that told my mom. Mama, like, she's like, what is that?
Oh, my God, what is that? Yo. Oh, my God.
We go up to the school the next day. And I don't know how he had my father's number, but he literally texted him and said, I literally have your daughter's phone. So, the boy got expelled, but, because he stole my phone. He did not find that, find that thing. He literally stole it. Irregardless, the moral of the story is, these behind little boys ain't nothing. How you steal my phone because we got into an argument? And because you with my best friend. The drama was, like, the tea was so hot in second grade. Like, literally, remember, I got a whooping. Me, I got a whooping because this nigga stole my phone and sent me a dick pic. At the tender age of what? How old was I in the second grade? Literally, like, 8? Nigga, you fast. Like, and I usually hate that word. Only because, like, it's mostly used for young black girls. But that was, like, one of the most fastest things you could have ever done. Like, even if your brother was in 5th grade, which I feel like was possibly the reason for him acting the way he was, because he was bad. He was a real bad kid. It's still real fast, especially since your brother was only in the 5th grade. It wasn't like your brother was in high school or anything like that. Tell me why I got my phone back literally a year later. Like, I had an HTC. Oh, that brings me back. I had an HTC. Got my phone taken for a literal year. A literal year. Or was it the summer? I really don't remember. Oh. I'm about to be so cute. Yeah, we about to listen to some music. Because I'm getting bored. We're going to Spotify. I like my shirt. I got Naruto on it. And my camera keep on doing this. Okay, y'all, because my camera really want to act out. And if you want to act out, we can act out. Yo. Yo. Yo.
If you want to know what a motherfucking boss looks like, bitch, you looking at one. A bitch that handles big business.
I'm gonna have to put like a funny voice over the music, or like speed it up or something, or like slow it down, skip, because I'm not gonna get copyrighted. I get copyrighted too many times, I swear. Oh, I cannot wait to look like somebody sexy behind Auntie. Oh, hold on, because it's really about to look like I got a silk press. And what? I don't know, should the part be on this side? Ooh, it's giving Elvis Presley. But fuck you, thank you very much, Elvis Presley. Y'all ain't know about this.
New to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me.
This song really got me in my feelings, especially with all the stuff I'm going through right now. Boy, why? Don't mind
waste time. Tell me what to do, just tell me when it hurts. When I get you to myself,
and you forget the shoes that were. And I ain't talking about my stroke.
Ooh, ooh,
but girl, I'm giving you the.
Trust me, trust me. Your life, I wish you would come home. But I'm just trying to balance my space. I'm the pain, but not let it feel the pain.
Thank you.
Don't feel I've lost in my dream. Is there more like us?
Andrew!
Waking up, feeling like the thankful one. Counting my ones, lacing up my f***.
Y'all not ready for this one.
We got go things to do.
We've been on this road too long, too long. Stay with us.
We make a song. Doing what we gotta do to get from
A to B.
Protection. Sex until that connection is restored. I know that sounds immature. Y'all know nothing about this one. Y'all know nothing about this. Y'all know nothing about this.
A New York nines and everywhere else six. Time wise, the opposite goes for chicks. I'm in a taxi, texting with my best friend. He's sleeping with.
I'm a mess.
That was wrong with shit. That was true.
Don't bring your girlfriend here. It's just you.
Living out of DK. Like, you ain't
working on a screenplay.
Like, your baby daddy ain't a DJ.
I don't know nothing about this.
Never have I seen someone so pretty. Wow, it's pretty wild. Cause she's all I've been wanting, yeah.
Y'all know nothing about this. I bet y'all don't know nothing about this. This Kid Cudi and took up my tip.
Ooh, y'all felt that? I felt that. Let's put that together.
I'm gonna get, don't take it out on me, no. Don't do me dirty.
Yeah, I'm liking this now. But I got a whole lot of forehead out. I'm really feeling like this is like this is it. And I know like what you're probably thinking, like you did nothing but installed it. But like the hair is flowy and I wanna cut it, but like it's also 5 o'clock in the morning and I'm also tired. I have work and I don't know. I think I actually wanna get in the bed and but like let me see if I cause I wanna do I wanna do a little edge? Look, I'm tired of this coming out my like but no, like I feel like if I was to do edges it would mess up the natural look that I got going on. Look how melted that lace is. I feel like it would mess up the look that I have going right now. I need to wipe off the excess. Okay, but let's talk about it because it literally looks like that grew out of my scalp. Like literally like I ate down that melted into my head. The excess is kind of making me mad. Yeah, I'm not going to do no edges and this is really the end of the video. Like, subscribe, comment down below, share this video with your mommy, your daddy, your auntie, your sister, your cousin. Share this whole video with your family. Because I did my big one, like I always do. I always do my big one. Yeah. Yeah. I'm about to clock out and go to sleep because it's like 6 o'clock in the morning now. Maybe 7. Yeah. Bye.